hope you enjoy your weekend. Today is really sunny day. It's a summertime in Melbourne. Hope you guys really enjoy the weather. Today we are gonna talk about 7 facts of being a pastry chef. Let's get started. Number 1, long hours. In this industry, you will need to work for long hours, mostly 10 to 12 hours a day, because the boss actually doesn't want to pay more staff because the labor cost is pretty high. So they have to start maybe from 6 until 6 or 10 until 10 p.m. because they don't want to pay someone from 6 until 2 and then another one coming from 10 to 6. If they have functions by the end of the day and they have to stay longer, sometimes they don't get any extra pay. Number 2, standing all day. So working in the commercial kitchen, normally you don't have chair inside the kitchen, and then it's not comfortable enough to working preparing food or cooking something while sitting. Once I put a step counter from my iPhone, and by the end of the day I can easily hit 10,000 steps in a day. My leg is really sore as well, that you just want to lay down in your bed. Next, no weekends. So if you're working in the cafe or restaurants that open on the weekend, Saturday and Sunday, you probably have to come to work. For some cases, maybe they allow you to have one day off on the weekend and one day off on the weekdays. I think that's fair enough, right? Since then, most the chef doesn't have really normal social life like normal people do. Next, working in the early morning. Pastry chef or bakers, when they need to produce yeast product or pastry, they require to work really early. They need to start at 2 a.m. or 3 a.m. Sometimes they start even at night. They start at 11 p.m. They need to make the product and be ready by 6 o'clock or 7 o'clock so they can deliver it to other shops, or they can start open the shop by 7 o'clock when the product is ready. People start come in and buy your product for their breakfast. Next, late lunch. If you need to do the service or a la carte, you probably have a late lunch around 2 or 3 p.m. sometimes 4 p.m. because you have to do the service, and sometimes you don't even have time for breakfast, maybe just a slice of toast and a couple cups of coffee to keep you awake. That's why some of the chef is really thin or a bit chubby, because they don't care actually what food they eat. They just eat anything fast and easy, you know. By the end of the day, they just buy some fast food for their dinner, you know. Next, stamina. Working in the kitchen, it's really need a good stamina, because you have to standing whole day and then you need to carry heavy liftings. Pastry chef requires you to carry at least 15 to 20 kilos, because if you work in a small team, you probably doesn't have kitchen hand. You have to carry a bag of flours, a bag of sugars, or a big block of butter. So you have to be really fit. Number 7, last but not least, perfectionist. You work in the pastry section. When it comes to plating or decorating individual cakes, it has to be perfect. One another has to be identical. And when it comes to slicing the cakes, it has to be perfect in size, really neat, and have a clean cut. That's why you have to pay attention to details, that every decoration and every element has to be the same one and another. So that's 7 facts of being a pastry chef. Hope you enjoy my video and you learn something new and what to expect to be a pastry chef. But don't feel too much pressure, just enjoy what you do and remember what is your passion, because I think this job is really rewarding by the end of the day, that you can produce so many products in a day and you can produce a beautiful and tasty product. Really, really rewarding for me, and I think for some of you guys as well. So hope you enjoy my video, like, share, and subscribe. See you next time. Bye.